The Elder Scrolls games are renowned for their richly detailed open worlds, which the player is free to explore, and having sold more than 50 million copies worldwide, with 3 Game of the Year awards to boot, I think it's pretty safe to say that this series of games is perhaps one of the most enjoyed and critically acclaimed out there. The success of these games has translated to YouTube as well. There are countless videos across YouTube which discuss and delve into the game's deep lore and gameplay aspects. However, I don't think anyone has ever made a video dedicated to the meaning behind the series being called The Elder Scrolls, so that's precisely what I'm going to be looking into today. It's important to realise what The Elder Scrolls truly are before we delve further into their meaning as a title. The Elder Scrolls are mysterious artifacts which simultaneously archive past, present, and future events. They often tell of events which require a hero to solve them, although the scrolls have never suggested who that hero might be. Some speculate that the Elder Scrolls are a product of the Aedra. However, there's no tangible evidence to suggest that this is really the case. As far as we know, the Elder Scrolls have no author, and they have been present in the universe since time first began. The number of Elder Scrolls present in the world seemingly fluctuates, and no one really knows why. To the average person's eye, an Elder Scroll appears as a sort of mass of jumbled foreign letters, not dissimilar to the letters found on the Eye of Magnus. It is through this link that some have attributed the Elder Scrolls to the Aedra, since the writings found on the Elder Scrolls and on the Eye of Magnus are indeed said to be of the Aedric language. But, as I said before, there's no concrete evidence which supports this link. The only individuals who can discern the Elder Scrolls, apart from a few other select individuals who I'll mention later, are the Moth Priests of the Cult of the Ancestor Moth. These Imperial Priests believe it is their sacred duty to interpret the Elder Scrolls in order to aid the Emperor, and it takes countless years of practice before any priest is able to attempt a true reading. Any information that is discerned from a scroll is never absolute. Rather, the scrolls typically reveal a series of possible futures to the reader. It is only when an event prophesied in an Elder Scroll has come to pass that that event becomes permanently part of that Elder Scroll, removing all other potential series of events predicted before. Reading an Elder Scroll comes at great cost to the reader. Each new foretelling and interpretation strikes the reader with a greater degree of blindness, and this is why every retired Moth Priest is completely blind. I did mention that there are a number of individuals beside the Moth Priests who can read the Elder Scrolls. Most notably, the Dwemer of Antiquity developed advanced technology in the form of the Lexicon, which allowed them to read and catalogue a scroll's contents without becoming blind. So, in relation to all this, why are the Elder Scrolls games called The Elder Scrolls? Well, believe it or not, there's actually a direct answer to this question from Bethesda itself. Apparently, when they were developing the game, they hadn't even decided what an Elder Scrolls was yet, and they simply decided to give the series of games that name since it stood out and sounded quite impressive. As they made more games for the series though, they then built upon the ideas of The Elder Scrolls, and so, rather than the title being tailored to The Elder Scrolls in-game themselves, perhaps The Elder Scrolls in-game are modelled from the title, and so they could still tell us something about the title's meaning. It's quite likely that as the idea of the Elder Scrolls progressed, the title began then to mean something, and maybe the developers wanted to imply something through the way they modelled the in-game Elder Scrolls off the title. The Elder Scrolls predict and record events that are pivotal to the future of Tamriel, and they make clear the roles of heroes in the events that they show. The scrolls act as an unbiased account of events that have already passed or are yet to come, and in a way, this fits in perfectly with the title of every Elder Scrolls game. Each game has the subtitle The Elder Scrolls, which implies that each game's events are indeed present in an Elder Scroll. For example, Skyrim's storyline is predicted and recorded in The Elder Scroll of the Dragon. It could be that the reference to the Elder Scrolls before the title of each game refers to the idea that the events of every game are predicted in an Elder Scroll. When a player first begins a game, the events in the Elder Scroll relating to that game remain uncertain. However, upon completing the main quest, the game's events then become recorded as objective truth in the Elder Scroll. It could be then that each game itself is simply a telling from an Elder Scroll, which we have the privilege to experience.